Baka Falanco, eh? Dorma Mundicum, na. Baka Falanco and Guy and Ga. Dorma Mundicum, na. In Tape Lindo, eh? In Tape Lindo, eh? In Tape Lindo, Zide Zaguna, Pagani, eh? Baka Falanco, eh? Dorma Mundicum, na. Baka Falanco and Guy and Ga. Dorma moon like him na.
In tape lindo, eh? In tape lindo, eh? In tape lindo, zine zaguna bagani, eh?
Baka Falanco, eh? Dorma moon like him na. Baka Falanco and Guy and Ga. Dorma moon like him na.
In tape lindo, eh? In tape lindo, eh? In tape lindo, zine zaguna bagani,
thank you. Bennett out there. We are just waiting for our children to come back from the woods. Welcome, everybody. Keep going, drummers.
Fungalapia, ashe, ashe, a fungalapia, ashe, ashe. Thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning, Jeffrey.
Good morning. Thank you. And a heartfelt welcome to Emerson to each of you. My name is Jeffrey Jacoby, and I am a member of the worship team, the choir, and the story troupe here at Emerson. A special welcome to those of you who may be joining our service for the first time, whether here in person or online. We hope you are nourished in heart and mind by our worship today. As a Unitarian Universalist congregation, we welcome a wide variety of theological and spiritual beliefs. We honor the inherent worth and dignity of each and every person. You are welcome here. This month, we explore the theme of story and the many stories that make up our lives and define who we are. And today, we have quite a special story for you. Reverend Deborah and our beloved story troupe, with some help from a few extra thespians, and our Emerson musicians will tell you a tale of discovering buried treasure.
Ooh.
Wow.
There you go. Before we begin.
I think they need a little warming up.
Yeah, exactly. They're getting there.
They're so used to sitting on Zoom doing this during service, right?
Yeah, hearing about treasure is going to get everybody warmed up.
All right, good.
Before we begin, I invite you to please take a moment to greet those around you or those on Zoom in the chat with our congregational affirmation. We need not think alike to love alike.
Here, it sounds like adventure.
Wow.
Ooh, yeah. This is a participatory service. I'm sorry if you didn't get the memo. That sounds like an adventure.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's COVID time, so you know, not too loud. Sorry. Good morning, everybody. I am Reverend Deborah Bennett, and it is a delight to see you all and to be with you all and all of you online. How many people do we have online? Do we have anybody online? Okay, a couple people. Hi, people online. Nice to see you. Well, thank you for joining us and joining us to have some fun today. It is going to be a fun day. We are celebrating Emerson's 39th birthday. Whoa. So without any further ado, my friends, let the discovery begin. Suit up, mateys. Oh, and I knew that. Suit up, mateys, and let's light our chalice. We had to suit up before they could light the chalice because we have two little pirates lighting our chalice for us.
Hello? Hi. Okay, our chalice lighting words come from Laura Thompson. Across the distance, the light from within me shines, sending love to all. Across the distance, your light is fuel that warms me and helps to keep my own light burning. Together, we keep the flame of community burning bright. We light this chalice to honor those who had the vision for this treasured community.
Thank you, Gregor and Tamsin. Nope, you're right in there. Awesome. Thank you. Well, let me tell you a tale, my friends. This is a tale of adventure and love and discovery. Now, it all began a long, long time ago in a land far, far, or maybe not so far away. And this tale, like any good old tale, had a treasure. Ooh. And since there must be a treasure, there must be a... Sorry, we only rehearsed once. This is going to happen all day, so you're going to stay with a treasure map. Because how else can one find buried treasure without our treasure map? Now, our story begins with two very special pirates, and I think I see them right over here. To quote our pirate, Now, these two special pirates had sailed the seven seas and one day came to rest on an island home. Now, these pirates had the blessing of seven pirate children.
Wow.
And together they were very happy, singing and dancing with music. But one day, while they were singing and dancing, a big storm came up. And it shook the island on which they lived. And it shook their thatched roof house, and it shook every tree, and it shook their pirate flags. And the winds were so fierce, the story goes, that it lifted up those seven tiny children and blew them away, spreading them to the seven directions. One went north, and one was blown south, one was set east, and one was set west. One was sent up into the sky and into the mountains, one down into the valleys below, and one little one got spun all the way around and around and around inside himself and disappeared. Finally, the winds calmed down, and the sun came out. And the pirate parents sat all by themselves looking around. Now, you would think that the pirate parents would be devastated when they realized that their precious seven children were gone. But, on the contrary, they sat there with sly smiles on their face. You can't see them under the mask, but they are smiling slyly. Now, to be sure, it was not because they did not love their little ones. They loved their children dearly. But you see, they knew something that not even the children knew themselves. Now let me explain. The pirate parents had once had a treasure map, the very treasure map you saw. And when their children were born, they had this brilliant idea. They took that treasure map and they cut it into seven little pieces. And they put one piece of the treasure map in the pocket of each of the seven children. And the parents had always said to the children, they always kept repeating this one thing. Kids, you know how parents do that? Yeah? Shake your head, children. Like, yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, anyway, these pirate parents kept repeating the same thing, and they kept saying, If you are ever lost, just follow your heart home. Now, at the time, the children thought that was kind of silly advice. They lived in this little island, and they knew the whole island well, and they thought, well, we're never going to get lost. But luckily, the children were wearing those 7 jackets when they got blown away, and luckily, they kept those jackets when they got older. For indeed, many years passed. We didn't do many years past music. Many years. Many years passed, and over time, the children grew up, and they lived lives like adults do, and they did all those adult-y things. And because they had been so little when the storm had swept them away from their parents, all the memories of that time had faded in the background. Although, if they were each honest, they would tell you that there was something tugging at their hearts that they could not explain. And then, on the 39th anniversary of the big storm, each of the children had an amazing thing happen. They each found that long-lost, forgotten treasure map. Let's see what happens next.
The first to find their piece of the treasure map was Pirate Annie. Strangely, she had tucked her jacket away under a shelf of cookbooks. And one day, while searching for a recipe for cassoulet, she discovered the jacket right there under her dog-eared copy of The Art of French Cooking. We love Julia. She pulled it out and noticed something in the pocket. She reached inside, and lo and behold, it was a piece of a treasure map.
Ooh.
What good is a piece of a treasure map? She said out loud. And she almost tossed it away. But then some deep memory in her heart stirred. Now, truth be told, there was something that Annie had been searching for all her adult life, but she wasn't quite sure what it was. She had gone here and there and had some good times and some not so good times, and through it all, something tugged at her heart. As she took a second look at the piece of the map, she found herself hoping beyond hope that the treasure she wanted would be what she would find. Now, she looked at the map closer, and guess what? The beginning spot on the map was exactly where she was.
Ooh.
What a surprise.
Exactly. Annie was a little surprised, but her heart kept urging her on, so she followed the map. She went east, then west, and north, and south, and up, and down, and all around. And finally, she came upon the spot with a big X. And you know what that means?
A treasure chest.
Slowly, but with hope, Annie opened the treasure chest. And there, inside, was her heart's true desire, music and worship.
Ooh.
Music and worship, that was it. Annie had always felt something call her, but wasn't sure what. And now she knew it was music and worship that would enliven her heart. As Annie picked up the music and worship, she felt a sense of home, calling her now even more intently. She knew she was to continue on her journey, and so she did.
So let's join.
Let's join with Annie now in sharing music and worship, singing Wo Ya Ya.
Yeah.
Now, at the same time Pirate Annie was discovering her heart's calling, little Pirate Susie found herself sitting all alone in a room. She too had had a life with some good times and some not so good times, but it wasn't until she slowed down enough to notice that she felt that there was something kind of missing. What was it? And one day, while editing another piece of writing, obviously written by someone who totally was unaware that a semicolon could not just be randomly thrown in to signify taking a breath, Pirate Susan got up, walked to her closet, reached in, and pulled out her childhood jacket. At first, she barely remembered where it came from, but she had the incredible urge to search the pockets, and you know what she found?
Piece of treasure map.
Wow. Yes, she did. And guess where that treasure map started? Right exactly where she was, the exact place she was standing. And something deep inside her stirred. Perhaps this will lead to what I am looking for, she said. So, given that she really was a pirate at heart, she set off. And she went east and west and north and south and up and down and all around and finally. She came to this spot with a big X, and you know what that means?
A treasure chest! Woo.
Slowly but with hope, Pirate Susan, opened the chest, and inside was care, deep spiritual care, open hearts, and listening ears. It is what she had been looking for her whole life, and she felt a sense of home, calling her now more intently than ever, and she knew she was to follow this experience of open hearts and listening ears and continue on her journey. And let us now pause ourselves for our own spiritual care as we share joys, sorrows, and concerns from our community. Thank you, Mary Nell.
Good morning. Can you hear me? This isn't very stable. My name is Mary Nell McLaughlin. I'm not Susan Ullman, who was in the order of service. But Susan and I both serve on as a member of the pastoral care team. Pastoral care team members are available with listening ears and caring hearts to support you during challenging times. You can contact us at email pastoralcare@emerson.org. At this time in our service, we pause to share personal joys, sorrows, and concerns of our Emerson community. Each Sunday, we light our vigil bowl. Its light represents the light of hope for the peaceful resolution of conflicts on our planet. And it honors all dedicated people who serve us, including those on the front line of the COVID-19 virus battle. We also light a special candle of acknowledgement for the Cherokee and Muscogee nations of people who lived on this land before us. May this candle remind us of our interconnection, and may our actions help heal all nations of people. Now, Reverend Deborah will light our candles as I share these joys with you today. I'm sharing my personal joy. What a beautiful day, and isn't it wonderful that we can celebrate together outside. Yeah. If you are on Zoom, you can type in your joys, sorrows, and concerns on chat. Now I share this concern. Keep Dominic Thomas in your prayers as he is having ACL repair surgery this coming Tuesday. As I know from my son, ACL repair is a very long recovery and it's very painful. So, Dominique, we wish you luck. Now, a sorrow.
We're gonna have virtual candles.
Virtual candles, okay. That's good. We can, you know, visualize them in our minds. This message is from Lauren Hayden Hoan on behalf of her husband, Daniel. Please join our family in celebrating the life of Daniel's mom, Catherine Wilson, after her sudden passing last weekend. Please hold Daniel and his brother, Joel, in your hearts as they navigate the world as part of her legacy, being a remarkable mother, sister, and friend. We also know there may be joys, sorrows, and concerns that are too tender to share. Feel free to speak or type into the chat the name of someone you are holding in your heart today. Let us send our heartfelt caring intentions to all people everywhere by offering the Buddhist prayer of loving kindness. The words are on Zoom and printed in the order of service. May all beings be filled with loving kindness. May they be free from harm and suffering. May they be well in body, heart, and mind. May they be at peace. Blessed be.
Thank you, Mary Nell. Thank you all for holding each other so beautifully during this time together and all the ways that you do. And let's get back to our story. What do you say, Pirate Jeffrey?
I'm ready to get back to the story.
All right, let's do that. Now, just as Pirates Annie and Susie were following their treasures, little Pirate Nicky, who was the shyest of the little pirate boys, he was actually looking in the kitchen for a snack in the pantry. He has to get to the pantry really quick. And lo and behold, right behind the graham crackers and the marshmallows, Nick found his jacket. Well, he found a jacket. Nicky, too, was having a fine adult life, and he was having good times and bad times and all those things. But he also had that strange sense that there was something he was looking for that he wasn't quite finding. Now, when Nicky found the jacket, of course, his first thought was to look into the pocket, because that is what all curious people do. And also because there wasn't any chocolate in the pantry and he was kind of hoping the chocolate was in the pocket. It wasn't, but lo and behold, he found
a piece of map.
Mm-hmm. And just like Annie and Susie, the treasure map started
right
where he was.
Right where he was. Do you believe that? What a coincidence. So, Nicky grabbed a few graham crackers. You believe that, Bruce?
I absolutely believe that.
You do? Okay, good. So, Nicky grabbed a few graham crackers, and in hopes of finding chocolate and his heart's desire, he followed the map. And he went east, and he went west, and he went north, and he went south, and he went up, and he went down, and he went all around. And finally, he came upon other direction, Pirate Nicky. Finally, he came upon a big X marking the spot, and you know what that means? Slowly but with hope, Nicky opened the chest. And there inside was his heart's true desire, tools and technology. Oh, how Nicky loved tools. He loved tools a lot. Yeah.
That's tools.
That's tools.
That's technology, folks.
So Nicky loved tools and technology, and he wanted to help others with them. So he picked up those tools and felt a sense of home, calling him more intently than ever, and he continued on his journey.
So let us take a moment to use the tools and technology we have been given to be of service. Our mission at Emerson is to seek truths, celebrate differences, act on our Unitarian Universalist principles, inspire the best in each of us, and serve the world. Our mission is made possible through the generous time, talent, and financial contributions of members, friends, and guests. One way we live into our mission is by partnering with other organizations committed to creating justice, peace, and compassion in the world. Each month, we choose an organization and encourage our members and friends to contribute both financially and through action to their work. This month's partner organization is Must Ministries Lunch Summer Lunch Program. Summer often means many of our neighbors are wondering how they will feed their children lunch every day. Must provides a nutritious lunch each summer weekday to thousands of children. At this time, we ask you to consider making a financial contribution to Emerson and to the Must Ministries Summer Lunch Program. Virtually, yeah. You can do that by text. It's on the online chat, or go to emersonuu.org and you'll be directed. Our collection today will be shared equally between both organizations. Any amount is appreciated, and we thank you for putting your values into action.
And for those that have the Realm app on your phone, it's really easy because you just hit the word giving on the Realm app. Ooh.
And if you go to emersonuu.org, you'll be directed to our online giving platform where you can contribute to Share the Basket, and you also have the option to make an additional contribution to the Must Ministries Summer Lunch Program if you choose. The offering will now be gratefully received.
Now everybody has permission to get out their phones. Thank you all, and I hope you're enjoying the Share the Basket. We thought it was a way to bring more attention to our partner organization every week. And you can always just make contributions to that organization as well each week. So thank you for that. Now, I hadn't mentioned it before, but two of the pirate children, it turns out, were actually twins. And when the wind had blown them, it had blown one way up into the mountains and the other low into the valley. And on the exact same time, these two siblings, Pirate Paulina and Pirate Jillian, were having a similar experience. Now, Pirate Paulina was busy with her own young children, doing all the things that a good mother does, loving them and caring for them and playing for them. And there were good days and challenging days. And one day, as they played amongst the fields and the stream, Paulina felt a little tugging at her heartstrings. It made her feel a little unsettled in her tummy. And truth be told, at first, she thought it might be indigestion from eating too much mint chocolate natamu, frozen dessert. But... But eventually she had to admit it was something more calling her.
Meanwhile, Pirate Jillian, being a twin, was having the exact same experience as Pirate Paulina. Jillian had her own children and was a good mother, having fun days and some less fun days. And though she loved her children very much, she too was aware, as they played with their pet rat, that something more was calling to her.
Now, it turned out that as they were playing in the stream one day, Pirate Paulina happened to look to her left, and lo and behold, hanging from a tree, she discovered a jacket. A jacket she had a vague memory of. Could this be my childhood jacket that I had thought I had forgotten? Yes, it was. And with a clear instinct, Paulina reached into the jacket pocket, and you know what she found?
Treasure map.
Yes, it was a little weather-beaten, spending so many years outside under the tree, but she could tell it was a treasure map that started
right where she was.
Pirate Jillian was busy with her own young children cleaning out the pet rat cage, and by some miracle there, underneath the cage was a jacket. At first she thought it was one of her children's jackets. After all, she had four children, and she can't be expected to remember which one had which jacket when. But then she took a closer look and recognized it as her favorite childhood jacket. And of course she was curious, so she looked into the pocket, and there was a piece of a treasure map. Of course it had a few nibbles around the edges from the rats, but she could tell the map started at the exact same place where she was standing.
So what were the two pirate twins to do but set out on their journeys? And so they each went east and west and north and south and up and down and all around. And at the exact same moment, they came upon the spot with a big X. And you know what that means?
Treasure chest. Pirate Paulina and Jillian rushed over to the X spot, arriving at the exact same time. In an instant, they realized they were staring at their long-lost twin. Overjoyed to see each other, but maintaining social distance, they uncovered the treasure chest, and slowly but surely, they opened the lid, and, sure enough, there inside were two treasures, one for each of them. Something that their hearts had called them to.
Pirate Paulina smiled as she lifted Justice out of the chest. Yes, she had found Justice, working for Justice and naming Justice. Yes, woohoo, we can say woohoo.
Yay! Woo.
That was what her heart was calling her to, and she took Justice out of the treasure chest. She knew there had been many that had come before her to work for Justice, and she wanted to join them in the fight.
Pirate Jillian started to laugh with delight as she pulled out Faith from the chest. She had found Faith, faith in learning and exploring. Yes, that was it, learning and exploring. That is what called Jillian's heart, and she took Faith exploration out of the treasure chest. Jillian knew that exploring and learning what life was about, and that so many had paved the way before her, and she wanted to continue to grow and learn.
And Paulina and Jillian both felt that call to continue their journeys, and so they did. And as they walked, they both hummed a tune in honor of the wisdom that came before and that was now guiding them home.
I am standing on the shoulders of the ones who came before me. I am stronger for their courage. I am wiser for their words. I am lifted by their longing for a fair and brighter future. I am grateful for their vision, for their toiling on this.
To cry for a moment. That wasn't in the script. Thank you, Millie. And thank you, Fred and Marjorie. And thank you, Ed Miller. Where's Ed Miller? He's one of our founding members. Hearts to you, Ed. And thank you to all who have come before us, each and every one of you that has been here to welcome the new folks that have each come. And we each have been a new folk at one point. Now, you may know that you think what's about to happen in our story next, and you're right. Another one of our pirate children happens to stumble upon their jacket. Well, actually, they didn't stumble upon it. Faster, swim faster. They swam upon it. Little Pirate Wynn had always been a wonderful swimmer and swam here and there and everywhere. And one day, while out splashing around in a beautiful lake, Pirate Wynn took a stroke, and lo and behold, there her hand hit something. At first, she was quite frightened, because even pirates get frightened once in a while. But quickly, though, Pirate Wynn realized it was a jacket. And just as quick, because Pirate Wynn was very quick thinking, Pirate Wynn realized it was the jacket from when she was a child. And although the jacket was quite wet, it was obvious that there was something in the pocket. So reaching in, there it was, a very wet
treasure map.
And you know where that treasure map started?
Right where she was.
Right in the middle of the lake. That's where that treasure map started. So what was a former pirate to do but to follow the map? So she went east and she went west and she went up and she went down and north and south and all around. And finally came to the spot with a big X. And you know what the X means?
Treasure map.
Pirate Wynn, who had a good life with some good times and bad times, also always had that feeling that something was missing. So as she lifted up the lid of the treasure chest, she was hoping she would find her heart's desire. And there it was, fellowship. Being in community with others, sharing values, that's Yay. What she treasured. So picking up
that's
the idea
fellowship.
Of fellowship, Pirate Wynn knew the journey was not over. She knew that she was called forward to continue, and so she did. Now, we are gonna take a moment to celebrate the calling of three new members who will sign our membership book today. Now, these three new people you probably are going to recognize a little bit because they've been around for a little bit. But we wanted to make sure they had a chance to sign our membership book. So, Wynn, do you want to take that mic over there? And Millie, are you able to come down? Millie? Miss Millie?
Millie,
we need roses, babe.
We need you, Millie.
We're going to do the members. Okay.
So, I'd like to ask Samantha Weinstein and Daniel Draven and Elizabeth Thomas to come forward.
And can I say, Wynn, the book I have in my hand is the original book from Emerson, and I'm looking, and there, in fact, I see Edmund Miller, Marjorie Macy, and Fred Macy. Isn't that amazing? Like the same book. So you get to sign the same book that hopefully each of you that are members have also signed.
They told me they have big smiles, but we can't tell. We've seen these people virtually for sure, but they haven't signed the book yet, so it's an exciting day. And if you will join with me, we are going to, in your order of service, the new members will recite in unison the new member part, and then the congregation, you, will follow with the congregational.
Do you have an order of service? Could someone run over some orders of service for us?
Here.
And then when you're done, you can come over and just sign.
Okay. We'll wait here for just a second. Okay.
And I think Samantha's helping us have new members in the congregation, aren't you, Samantha?
That's right.
Congratulations on your.
Yes, we've got a new member. Well, I'm sorry, I didn't introduce Aurora, who's also. New. Okay, so we enter this faith with hope and possibility in our hearts, pledging to participate in and support the of this congregation. We covenant to remain true to the spirit of love that flows through us and guides us. We seek your welcome as we join you in this faith. We are all connected. And congregation, would you respond, please? We welcome you as once we were welcomed. We seek to be open and inclusive, respecting your inherent dignity, your ideas, and your vision. We seek to be supportive, not only when you reach out to us in courage, but also when you need us to reach out to you. In return, we ask that you recognize our humanity. We will not always live up to our ideals, and when we fall short, we invite you to stay in relationship with us and help us more fully bring alive the spirit of love. We welcome you as an equal member of this congregation of faith, this faith, and of our shared spiritual journey. We are all connected. Please welcome them.
Many of us recognize Elizabeth Thomas, and she is partners with Dominic, woohoo, over there. And where's the rest of the gang? They're around. We have Clark, where's Clark? And Maddox, Theo, is Maddox here? No, okay. So Theo and Clark and the Thomas family, welcome.
So, Reverend Deborah, do you think that everybody's worried about the fact that we may have forgotten about Georgie?
I think they are worried that we forgot our last little pirate.
Well, in case you are, please don't, because we did not forget our last youngest baby pirate, Pirate Georgie.
He was all grown up now.
Little Pirate Georgie had grown up and was enjoying his adult life, well, almost. You see, as he grew, he did lots of things here and there and everywhere. He focused on this business and that business, but always felt something tugging at his heart, some new way of doing things he longed to try, something half remembered. And one day, as he was getting blur-eyed and wondering if the number 8 on the spreadsheet he was staring at was upside down or downside up, it hit him. It's time to find your jacket. It was like hearing words come from someone who was not in the room. At first, Pirate Georgie was a little scared.
He didn't find his jacket yet.
Oh.
Be scared. Somebody's talking to you. Be scared. Yeah, yeah.
But then he remembered, oh, yes, I did have a jacket when I was little. So he looked here and there and everywhere and eventually discovered that it was laying there right in front of him on a chair. This happens to adults sometimes. And Pirate Georgie picked it up and, yep, just like his siblings, rustled through the pockets and out fell some really old gum.
Oh.
And a really old mangled paper clip. And, oh, yes, a piece of treasure map. There it is. Okay. Whose trail started, guess where? Exactly where he was. So off he went. He went east, then west, and north, and south, and up, and down, and all around, and finally came upon the spot with a big X. And you know what that means? Yeah. And you know what that means? What is it? What is it? What's under there?
A treasure map.
Treasure chest?
Yes.
Slowly, but with hope, Pirate George opened the treasure chest, and there inside was his heart's true desire, inclusive leadership. That was it. That was what he had been looking for his whole life, the opportunity to be of service and to lead in an inclusive way.
Yeah. Ooh.
He felt a sense of home, and he knew he was to follow what was in his heart and continue on the journey. And so he did.
Hey, Pirate Georgie.
So how many of us can relate to these grown-up pirates? Somewhere along the line, we too may have been swept up in the storms of life, right? Swept away from what it felt like was our true home or our true heart's calling. Perhaps we got busy doing all the adult things we were told we ought to do. And we may enjoy some of those things, but often at some point in our lives, we come to feel that there's something tugging at our hearts, wanting our attention. Has anybody had that experience? Some voice nudges us not to stop where we are, not to settle for just figuring life out, not to settle for just figuring out how we're supposed to be in society and get the house and the car and the bank account and the 401k and the da 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 check, 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 check. For indeed, we feel a calling to do more than just get by in life or to just play by the rules. Right? We want to thrive. We want to grow. We want to discover and rediscover what our heart's calling is. We want to explore and learn and serve and to find others who share our values. And if we're lucky, we discover the hidden treasures inside of us, those things that bring us alive. You know what I mean? Who can say that they found something inside them that brings them alive? Anybody?
Oh, yes.
Have you?
Oh, yes. Many things.
Bruce, you have. I know you have.
I'm sitting behind most of it.
Oh, thank you. Oh, you mean your piano.
Music.
But we know when we've discovered that buried treasure in our hearts, because we do. All of a sudden, we have that zest for life, right? Maybe we're tired and we don't want to do this thing, but this thing brings us life and joy. And all of a sudden, we find ourselves willing to go on those adventures where we haven't gone before. We don't want to stay put anymore.
And west, and up, and down, and all around, until one day, at the exact same moment.
They're going to have to keep wandering because the treasure's not quite here yet. Wander some more.
They continue going east and west and up, and there was some more up and down, and there was some more all around. A little more east, a little more west. Oh, the treasure's on its way. Oh, it's not quite here. It's getting here, though, so they're still wandering until it gets here. They're making their way. They're making their way. They're going to find it. Sometimes a search, more of a search, makes it even better when you finally find what you're looking for. So they kept lurking and searching, searching and searching, until they all find themselves at the exact same place, a place marked with a big X, a big treasure chest.
And you know what that means?
A treasure chest. Instantly, the siblings had a spark of recognition, and in a socially distanced kind of way, they all hugged and got really excited to see each other.
But what about the X? Turning to the buried treasure, the pirates grabbed shovels and pickaxes and quickly worked to uncover their new treasure. They dug and they dug, and sure enough, there was a treasure chest. But what was this? This one had a lock on it. The lock was one of those locks with a code. It was a 7-letter code. Each space could be any of 26 letters of the alphabet.
This could take forever, Pirate Nick exclaimed as he lifted up one of his tools, preparing to smash the trunk open.
Maybe it needs us to just talk nicely to it, suggested Pirate Susan.
Or sing to it, added Pirate Anne.
As they looked at each other, little Pirate Georgie dropped his treasure.
Hey, look! Exclaimed Pirate Paulina and Jillian at the same time. There are letters behind our treasures. They all stared at the letters.
What do they spell? Asked Pirate Wynn.
E sermon? Answered Pirate Georgie, quite confused.
E sermon? Maybe more cern. More cern. Maybe that's it. It's more cern, said Pirate Nick. And they all began to quarrel. Okay, everybody. I'm breaking the wall, the third wall here. I think our pirates need some help. What do you think the treasure, what does it spell?
And sure enough, that was the code to the treasure chest. Welcome home, yelled Mama and Papa Pirate, sitting quite close to the treasure. The children rejoiced in seeing their parents once again. We knew if you followed your heart's desire that it would always lead you to a place where your own individual treasures would join together with others to make the best treasure of all.
And the best treasure of all is the place that feels like home. Welcome home, Emerson Pirates. Welcome home, everyone.
And we all lived happily ever after. The end.
And a special thank you to all of our thespians of the day. Jeffrey Jacoby, our co-narrator. Actors, Ann Mason, Susan Allman, Nick Jokay, Jillian Scow, Paulina Rivera, Wynn Scow, and George Clear. Come out and take a bow. And thank you to our father and mother pirates, Fred and George Macy. Our treasures, those beautiful treasures were created by Audrey Pickett Tice. Audrey, wave. Thank you to our most amazing stage and prop manager ever, the incredible Beth Klein. I just have to do this. Beth has worked so incredibly hard on all of this, so thank you so very much, Beth. And to our amazing musicians, Bruce and Sarah and Jeffrey and our drummers, Lisa Prispashniak, Jan Harding, Holly Emmendorf, Julia Benson, Slaughter, Corey Heister, Mo Brom, and Mark Cobb. Thank you, pirates. You may take your treasures with you. Now, before we end our service today, we do want to take a moment to appreciate all the treasures that we have right here at Emerson. So I'm going to ask our president of our Board of Trustees to join me, Ginger White. And together, we want to take a moment to appreciate all the dedication and love that each of you contribute to Emerson. There's an incredible amount of things that happen. Do you want to do the other mic? And so we want to offer you a small token of appreciation to all of you that have participated with clapping. And to our leaders, we're going to offer another small token of appreciation because it's really important that you be recognized for your work. It's no small thing to say, okay, I'll do that. And then it's no small thing to say, oh, okay, I'll lead that. Like, I'll step into those positions. So we really want to acknowledge those that do this. The list is quite long, so we're going to talk at quite a clip, so you can just kind of keep the clapping going as we go. And I'm going to invite folks to stand to be recognized for your participation. You want to start? Oops.
You know what? I think I left one page out here.
Oh, okay, then I'll take this page. First and foremost, we want to thank some of our original founders, which we have, and that is Fred and Marjorie Macy and Ed Miller. And Ed, you don't have to come forward right now, but if you can wave. Now, if you have contributed to our spiritual practice and care ministries, I'm going to ask you to stand or make yourselves known so we can clap for you. This would be our listening circle facilitators and participants, Buddha sitting group, Qigong practice group people, and those on our pastoral care team. Could you stand or just make yourself known? Let's hear for them. And then I'm going to ask the leaders to come forward, please. Susan Allman, who leads our pastoral care team, Ann Mason, Buddhist Sitting Group, and Mark Cobb, Listening Circles. Please come forward, and I'm going to offer you a little treasure. You guys can come forward and grab a treasure from the table. Are you missing a page?
I'm missing this page. I start here.
Thank you. Okay, there you go.
If you have contributed to our faith development ministries, please stand or make yourselves known. No, I don't have page 20.
Oh, you don't have that page? That would include all of our teachers, all of our RE teachers and assistants, anyone that's led an ARRR program, the Family Ministries Committee. Let's hear it for them. Thank you. And with these leaders, please come forward. Elizabeth Thomas, the Family Ministries Committee Chair, and Michelle Joquet, ARRR Chair. Thank you for your willingness to serve. And if you have contributed to our justice ministries, please stand or make yourself known. This includes Green Sanctuary Team, Immigration Justice Team, Racial Justice Team, the LGBTQ Welcoming Justice Committee, Share the Basket Committee, and Must Ministries. Thank you all for your justice work. And would these leaders please come forward? Nick Joquet and Denise Cardin for Green Sanctuary, Lisa Gonzalez, Karen Anderson Cordova for Immigration, Lisa Prishpashniak and Paulina Rivera for Racial Justice, James Poteet for LGBTQ Welcoming, Chris McConville for Share the Basket, Ann Mason, and Joe Tomachek for Must Ministries. Thank you so much. Yeah, so if it's your first time being caught up, you can take one of the treasures. Those of you that are caught up more than one, you get one treasure. Are you good?
I'm good.
Okay, great.
If you've contributed to the operations of Emerson with tools and technology, please stand or make yourself known. These include Buildings and Grounds Committee, Finance, Stewardship, Endowment, Fundraising, Aesthetics, Safety, Connect, the Leadership Development Committee, and the Policy Task Force. And let's also include our Committee on Healthy Ministries.
Thank you.
And would these leaders please come forward? Michael Myers, Facility, Nick Joquet, Grounds. Geez, didn't we just see him up here?
Yes, he can come up and just wave.
Eric Scow, Finance, Chris McConville, Stewardship and Leadership Committee, Shelley House, Fundraising, Trish Neitzel, Aesthetics, Richard Fuller, Safety, and Greg Castle for Connect, and Patty Haynes for the Policy Task Force, and Noelle Garwick and Alex Spitzer for Healthy Ministries. Thank you for your willingness to lead. Good to meet you.
Thank you, Alex. Isn't it amazing the small congregation we are, how many people have stepped up to participate and lead in things? I just think that's really awesome. So let's move on to fellowship. So if you've contributed to fellowship this year, please stand or make yourself known. This would be working with hospitality, greeters, helping hands, or if you've led any of the affinity groups, Spanish Learning Circle, or even if you just participated, the book groups, writers groups, please stand and thank you for sharing your treasures. And I'm going to ask these leaders to come forward. Wynn Scow, our membership committee leader, Colleen Radbill, hospitality, Judy Griffin, who is recovering from surgery. Thank you, Judy, if you're online. Greeters, Kathy Bailey, helping hands. Thank you.
Now let us recognize our worship ministries. Please stand or make yourself known if you have contributed to Sunday worship team, the story troupe, our worship's assistants, and let's include our dedicated AV team. Yes. Thank you for sharing your treasures. Yes. Leslie McLean, please come forward to be acknowledged as the Sunday's worship committee leader, and Keith Eklund, our AV team leader.
Keith. Let's take an extra big hand for these AV team. I mean, the AV team has just been just. You probably don't know this, but it took quite a lot to set up today and just every week over and over again. So thank you so much. All right, so now let's take a minute and, oh, let's see, we want to do cups as well. Do you want to just mention the cups?
Oh, yeah, sorry. Our cups group wants us to know that they are a collective and do not use a leader model. So let us take a moment now to appreciate all that the entire Emerson Covenant of UU Pagans offers us in ritual and practice. Please stand so we can thank you with our clapping.
Anybody from cups here?
Cups.
All right, now I'm going to take a minute to talk about music. What a year. It's not an understatement that we miss dearly our choir, right, in the regular way. But we have been blessed that so many people in our choir have agreed to be hymn singers and create all those beautiful pieces that we have gotten to see online to be part of our virtual choirs. Under the leadership of Kathy Middleman, and I will be acknowledging staff in a minute, so we will be big cheers for them in a minute. We also will acknowledge the Choir Leadership Committee, which has kept things going on. So Choir Leadership Committee, if you're here, could you stand and make yourself known? Also, if you've been on the worship team, oh, did we already do worship team? Worship
yeah.
Music, okay. Or how about worship music in general, any worship music in general? Thank you. It's definitely been a big team effort, and Kathy Middleman and I were speaking, and we felt that there was one person who needed a special mention for his above and beyond contributions this year. Now, it turns out that this person also needs a special recognition for several other fronts of above and beyond. So I'm going to ask Dave Schimmel if you could please come forward, and sorry I didn't tell you this was going to happen. Dave has not only been instrumental in so many of the choir virtual pieces that he helped put together this year, he's also served as the treasurer on the board of directors, and he nodded politely when I said, let's change and move to Realm, and he like really is making that happen. So Dave made all that launch happening. He's also supporting with the new website launch. So really, I'm sure I'm forgetting things that you've done, Dave, but it's just like the list goes on and on. It's been an incredible year and really an amazing amount of work. So Dave, thank you so much. And I'm going to ask you to stay up here as Ginger acknowledges the Board of Trustees.
Please come forward as members of the Board of Trustees. George Clear, Vice President. Denise Cardin, Secretary. Operations Associates, Eric Scow, Uwe Neitzel, and Laura Trad. And I think Laura maybe is virtual.
Again, this is one of those tasks that is no small task, like getting together every month and multiple times sometimes in a month to talk about issues and work on things. So it's really been amazing. And we've got, Ginger, you want to grab the ones with the map on them and hand each one of those out? And if you guys could just stay there for a second, and we are going to also acknowledge our ministry associates. So this is the team that supports all the programming ministries, where these guys focus on the operations. So let me invite these folks up. Michelle Joquet, who focuses on faith formation. Lane LaFay, who I don't see is here. She is worship and music. Millie Fuller. Millie, time to come down. Where's Millie? Millie is fellowship. And Helen Hobson for justice. And then Paulina Rivera has also joined us for justice. So Paulina and Helen could come forward. And Mark Cobb is our newest ministry associate, and he's with worship, spiritual practice, and care. And again, these guys put in an incredible amount of extra effort in leadership. So thank you all. Ministry associates, on your way out. Oops, yep. Yay. And then on your way out, if you could come, and we're going to give you a little box too. And last but definitely not least, I wanted to take a moment to appreciate our staff. This isn't last, there's several more to go. I want to take a moment to appreciate our staff. So if you guys want to come on over, ministry associates and board, your excuse. See, they love meeting so much. They just, when they get together, they want to just stay there and keep going. Thank you all. Oh, do you want to do that?
Sure. Kathy Middleman, our choir director.
Woo!
Bruce King, music coordinator.
Woo!
Beth Klein, director of family ministries. And Maggie Baker, office administrator extraordinaire. And let me introduce the newest member of our staff, our AV lead technician, Stephen Lane.
Stephen, come on out. Where did they all go? Where's Kathy, Bruce? Come get a little treasure box, peoples. Where's Kathy? Oh, there you are. Do you want to come forward so we can see you and yell for you and do all those things? She's so shy. And I really want to say to the staff, I don't know where Maggie is. If she's, she might not, she was here earlier. These guys have really gone up and down and left and right and all around, and they spill things and they continue on.
We righted it.
And they write it. They write the wrongs of the world. And I just really, I want to personally just say thank you for all that you've done. It's just been an incredible year, as you can probably imagine, going from oops, let's go online, and just all the things that have happened this year. So thank you for doing that with us. You're amazing. Very, very blessed.
Finally, I get to see Kathy's toenails. They're lovely.
And I have one that's unscripted. That there's one person I want to acknowledge, and this person hasn't led a team this year, although she kind of did and then stepped back. But this is a person I want to acknowledge. I know so many of you have done so many things, and you know we've offered so much this year. But there's this one person that just kept showing up. If we offered something, she just came. And she came for all these learning things. And she sat there and I watched as she just engaged herself and learned again and again and again, whether it was racial justice or LGBTQ justice or Qigong. It was just she was I am going to just be here and be present. So even though she hasn't been a leader of a specific group this year fully, I want to really invite Bernadine Cataletta to come up, and I would like to acknowledge Bernadine. I know we don't have a member of the year and I don't want to do that, but I really have to acknowledge you, Bernadine. And my husband can attest to this. So many times I say to him, this woman blows me away. you just keep showing up. So thank you. Thank you for doing that. And please come and find a treasure for yourself, too. And ginger. Oh, Mom, maybe we should take the flowers down. Ginger, I'm going to cry if I say too much about Ginger. Ginger and I spend a lot of time talking, as you might imagine, and it's just been such a gift to work with you these last 2 years with all the changes and the ins and the outs and the ups and the downs and the alls around. And I love you dearly. And thank you. Something nice about me now.
And to our captain of this ship this past year, who has guided us through these uncharted waters so lovingly and confidently, and we couldn't have done it without you. And thank you.
Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Oh, I got a treasure. Oh, there's the chocolate, Nick. Little Nikki. I had the chocolate.
And French pudding.
Oh, Beth, you are too sweet.
Pirate guilt. And Trader Joe's.
All right, everybody come to see me after the picnic. I got booty. Oh, we're not allowed to share. Sorry.
Convenient.
All right, you guys have all been great friends. So first, Matey Bruce, can you take us out with you and your singers? Because we got a friend. Would like and join us.
Nothing is going right. me, and soon I will be there to brighten up even your darkest night. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you.
Housekeeping things. Millie's going to tell us how the food is going to go down to be safe. And Nick, little Nikki, is going to bring out a big ladder and take our family photo. So we want everybody to stay for the family photo. So stay right where you are. He's going to take that picture. And Millie, do you want to tell us how to do food?